Ravi de vous retrouver.
Delighted to find you on the red carpet with me again this evening. Earlier on, the festival was celebrating its 75th anniversary. But today, but rather now, we're getting back to the competition. We're going to have the only Italian film in the competition, the only Italian one out of the 21 in the competition. It's called Nostalgia, directed by Mario Martoni, and it takes us to Naples. A Neapolitan who's left the city, has been away for 40 years, and goes back after that 40-year gap and sees all the differences in the city there. But as you know, the Cannes Film Festival has many sections. We've got the Un Certain Regard section, of course. We are going to speak to one of the directors who is creating quite a buzz. It's the film Butterfly Vision.
You will show for the first time your movie. How do you feel about that? Because it is Cannes, glamorous, but it is also political.
Yeah, of course, the feelings are very intense, but ambiguous at the same time. Because, of, first of all, it's an honor to be here, and with this you feel an importance of the present moment of us, me and the crew, representing our reality, our country, our people. But of course, it's a bit stressful and painful to be in this
context,
in this safety, first of all, knowing that not of all the people we love are safe now. But we justify that with speaking out and making people aware, and of course representing us as the full members of this cultural brother and sisterhood of the independent nations.
Do you think it's important for Ukrainians to know you here, to speak out?
The Ukrainian whom?
The Ukrainian in Ukraine,
yeah.
For your people to know you are here and to speak out to the world.
Yeah, of course, all the reaction I got at home actually was people were happy because actually right now Ukrainians, they need good news. And of course, we all are very grateful and we rejoice every possibility to be heard.
So, enjoy for tomorrow. Good
Thanks
luck.
A lot.
And maybe a word of your actors and actresses.
Yeah, this is
How Rita do you feel? Is it the first time you're in Cannes, and for this project particularly, it must be very emotional?
Yeah, it's my first time in Cannes, and for me now it's like a strange and beautiful experience.
What do you expect for tomorrow?
You можете сказати українською, я перекладу.
Ага. Що я очікую? Я очікую, що буде заповнена зала, і ми будемо почутими.
So he also told he is expecting for a full house, and also he is awaiting to be heard this way.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Arrivé sur le tapis rouge de l'équipe de Butterfly Vision.
Et place au film en compétition.
And let's talk about Nostalgia. It's delightful. I'm delightful to see you here. You play the role of the main hero. Your name is Sophia Essaidi. So how come you got involved in that project? Well, it's just a phone call and an offer. It can be as simple as that. Yeah, it's just someone I met, and we set off on that wonderful adventure. Have you seen the film yet? No, I haven't. I'm so excited at the idea of seeing it with an audience as well, and with the rest of the cast. I think we're going to have a great time. You have some scenes abroad, and you're on the telephone a lot of times. So you did not act with them. No, I only acted with the guy who plays my husband. Rather lovely husband at that. So we had to learn Egyptian because we don't really speak that language naturally, so we had to learn it. Well, enjoy the screening. It's a wonderful film. Thank you.
C'est un jeune réalisateur né à Odessa et qui aura 32 ans cette année.
Bonsoir.
Good evening.
Vous pouvez vous rapprocher parce qu'évidemment tout va être traduit.
You can come close. There, everything will be translated. You are going to. You play the mother of the main character. Is that right? And your son has come home to see you in Naples. That's why he comes back to his home city. The scenes which you're in are absolutely beautiful to watch. Did it feel beautiful as you were acting?
Che bellezza! Mi dite delle cose meravigliose. Grazie infinite. Sì, sono state molto coinvolgenti, molto emozionanti ed ero molto spaventata perché era una grande responsabilità, un film di Mario Martone e Pierfrancesco Favino e io.
In French maybe. No, okay, not in French.
It was a privilege for me to be able to play the scene in a Mario Martone film together with Pier Francesco Favino. Fantastic.
Vous êtes une immense comédienne italienne de théâtre.
You're a very well-known actress in Italy. I think it's the first time here in Cannes. And how do you feel to be here in Cannes?
A Cannes è la prima volta ed è una grandissima emozione, un piacere eccezionale, un grande divertimento, grazie. A Venezia ho avuto il piacere due volte, sono andata, due bellissimi film e quando c'è da divertirsi io ci sto perché mi piace tanto divertirmi.
Merci beaucoup. Merci. Très bonne soirée.
I'm very, very excited. It's a real pleasure and it's fun. I've never been to Cannes before. I went to the Venice Film Festival twice, but wherever there's a possibility of having fun, I take it.
Très bonne soirée. Merci. Allez. Tous les deux ensemble,
both of you together, the director and the main actor. I'm going to start with the actor because he speaks French. Or perhaps you speak French as well. I would say that the main character is you and the city of Naples. The main character is, of course, the character you play, but also the city of Naples. Yes, Naples is an amazing and very important character in the film. But the neighborhood, in fact, where we're acting is a main player also. It's a very unique neighborhood. I think it's thanks to the neighborhood that we were able to create what we have created in this film. We wouldn't have been able to do it anywhere else.
Votre acteur est un peu le Robert De Niro italien.
Pier Francesco Favino is like your Robert De Niro.
Italian way. Do you agree with that?
I think it's much more than Robert De Niro. Francesco Favino, it was so beautiful to work together. So fascinating the trip, the voyage we did inside Naples. I'm Neapolitan, he is not Neapolitan, but we changed completely our positions. And we were together going in this trip.
I think you have to get to the march.
Merci. En tout cas, moi, je ne suis pas Robert De Niro. J'aimerais bien, ça serait un rêve.
I'm not Robert De Niro, but I really wish I could be. Well, enjoy your evening.
Et c'est donc l'équipe du film Nostalgia.
So that's the crew from the film Nostalgia. On the red carpet now. A film directed by Mario Martone, who we had a few words with, appelé alongside Pierfrancesco Favino, who is the lead male actor.
Francesco Di Leva, Thomas Oragno.
The film also stars Francesco Di Leva, Thomas Oragno, Aurora Quattrocchi, Sofia Esaide, who we had a word with. Mario Martone came to Cannes in 1995 with a film called L'amore molesto. So that's quite some time since he's been in competition. He was a member of the jury in 2000. He's one of the greatest Italian contemporary film directors, with Sorrentino, of course, who's also in Cannes, and Garrone. They both have presented many films here in Cannes.
L'héros principal, c'est Pier Francesco Favino.
So the lead actor is Pier Francesco Favino, one of the most talented actors in Italy right now. He has won many prizes.
Donatello, notamment.
The Donatello Prize.
C'est aussi l'acteur fétiche d'un
Also regular on Gabriele Muccino films. But he also acts internationally. He's worked with Spike Lee, Ron Howard,
Z de Mark Foster,
and Mark Foster.
Et pour ce qui concerne l'histoire de ce film,
and the story of this film,
c'est celle d'un homme.
Is that of a man about whom we know nothing at the very beginning? He comes back to his hometown of Naples after being away for 40 years. He lives in Cairo and he's married there.
À la recherche de ses racines, de ses souvenirs.
And he's come back home looking for his memories. He feels he needs to delve back into the city where he grew up. And there are many questions about his roots, how you leave your roots behind, how you go back to find them again. It's all in Naples, and that special neighborhood in Naples that they were talking about.
La Camorra fait loi.
Where, of course, there is the Camorra, but there is some resistance there as well.
C'est vraiment un film aussi qui a pour sujet principal la ville de Naples.
One of the main subjects of the film is the city of Naples and its craziness, its generosity.
Quand on parle de Camorra, ça fait forcément.
When we mention the Camorra,
Gomorra de Matteo Garrone.
One thinks of the film Gomorra, which won the jury prize.
Référence bien sûr.
And also Elena Ferrante and My Brilliant Friend, which has been made into a series. And here we have the crew from the film edging its way forward to Thierry Frémaux, who is there to greet them, the general manager of the festival. And he chose this film, Nostalgia by Mario Martoni, to be among the 21 that he selected out of 2,200, which he had to look at, to be in the list, therefore, of the 21 films in competition at the 75th Cannes Film Festival. And Aurora Quattrocchi, I had a few words with her. She's a very famous theatre actress in Italy. But she has also worked in the movies as well. And she's even worked with Wim Wenders. That was the film that he made about Palermo, Palermo shooting. Aurora comes from Sicily, whereas Mario Martoni comes from Naples. A final wave to the photographers, and then they'll be heading indoors to the movie theatre to watch the film. It's being screened for the first time to the public. So it's a premiere screening.
Dernier regard sur la nuit canoise.
Film très beau, très tendre.
A wonderful film, full of tenderness. Naples becomes a global city. The lead actor has come back to try and find out where his roots are, what his roots are, how he's become who he is, what he's running away from.
En exergue du film, cette phrase d'ailleurs, si on ne s'est pas perdu, on ne peut pas se retrouver.
And there's a quote in the film, if you never get lost, you'll never be able to find your way.
La phrase qui explique le film comme une
déambulation. And so that's a kind of explanation of the whole leitmotif of the film. And here we have the crew from the film, headed by Mario Martoli, entering into the screening room. They will all settle down on row I, which is reserved for the crew from the film. Of course, the footage which you're seeing here is unique on TV Festival. And when the lights go up at the end of the screening, you'll see them on TV Festival again.
27 ans donc que le réalisateur n'avait plus présenté un film en compétition.
So the director hasn't been to Cannes in competition for 27 years. Of course, he, in the meantime, he did come back because he was in the jury. He was in the main jury in 2000.
On sent que l'équipe prend vraiment plaisir à être
là. So we can see the pleasure on the crew's faces.
Et on crie Mario.
And we can hear people shouting out Mario.
Un des grands maîtres du cinéma italien.
He really is one of the great masters of Italian cinema. May not be the best known. He's certainly not the one who's been to the festival the most often.
Très intéressant avec Matteo.
However, him and Matteo Garrone and Paolo Sorrentino, they all represent Italian film today.